Hawaii has seen its share of road rage. An incident earlier this month led to the stabbing of three people on Oahu. Now there's a push to outlaw bad behavior on the road. Alexander Zanes is getting answers on what this could mean for drivers. Alexander?
Joe, if ultimately signed into law, the bill would add a new section to the traffic code, specifically targeting the behavior that is commonly referred to as road rage.
Stephen Wong has been behind the wheel teaching kids how to drive for over 10 years in Hawaii. He says he's just about seen it all.
I've had people show examples of road rage while I have students in the car pretty much on a daily basis, and definitely have examples of poor driving.
Just this month, a road rage incident on the H-1 freeway led to this barricade situation in Eva and landed Mark Char behind bars for attempted murder. A new bill introduced this month aims to curb these kinds of incidents by first laying out just what constitutes road rage. The bill outlines point by point just what isn't allowed, things like positioning or stopping your car to prevent someone else from moving, taking out a weapon or other dangerous objects, throwing things at another car, or yelling profanity or threats.
If you come across a situation where there's road rage or somebody may be getting agitated, is you don't want to make it worse, so you don't want to challenge them.
Wong says the last thing you want to do when you encounter someone with road rage is escalate the situation.
Never get out of the vehicle unless there's like an accident or something where you have to, but for a road rage situation, you don't want to exit the vehicle. You put yourself at risk, and it also gives it might give them the false impression that you're looking for a confrontation.
Now, the bill doesn't specify penalties for this type of behavior. It also doesn't address how these behaviors would be tracked and enforced by police. Alexander Zanes, KHON 2 News.